Mammoths, which is always good. Sure. I always wanted to be a paleontologist.
Thanks. Hello, I'm Jun Kai. I would like to introduce my project, our project, mapping the most massive overdenseness through hydrogen. So here is our collaborator, and here is the logo of the project. So we are trying to develop a technique to search for the most massive, the highest overdensity at Z of 2 to 3 through the Lyman alpha forest. So why we want to do that? Why the overdensity at 2 to 3 is interesting? The first is definitely the cosmology. So the abundance of and the mass of the Z is greater than 2 cluster or their progenitors, protocluster, will provide a stringent constraint to the cosmology and structure formation. But you should know that determined mass at ratio higher than 2 clusters is going to be very tricky. So it's maybe an important but long-term goal. But there are also some short-term goals, like mainly related to the galaxy formation. So because the overdensity is tracing the relatively more evolved environment, so the overdensity is an ideal site to study the emergence of the density color relations or density morphology relations, like the environmental dependence of the galaxy properties. And also, since it's tracing the very evolved environment, it's the ideal site to learn the very massive galaxy, the quenching fraction. So here is a nice plot from Newman 2014, say that majority of the galaxy in overdensity at Z of 1.6 are already quenched. So how about Z is greater than 2? So so when is the galaxy start to quench, and how the quenching process is a key process? It's key question in the galaxy formation. So, and also I would like to remind that Milky Way is in Virgo cluster. So I strongly believe that if we need to fully understand the evolution of Milky Way, we need to fully understand the evolution of the Virgo cluster. So, and the third motivation is the Z of 2 to 3 is a unique laboratory to study the galaxy intergalactic medium in interaction. So because Z of 2 to 3 is the peak of the both star-forming galaxy and the quasars, so at 2 to 3, we can have a very good sampling of the intergalactic medium through the absorption like tomography or the emission. So those are all the key questions that drive us to search for the highly matter overdensities at Z of 2 to 3. So traditionally, there are two ways to do that. First is people tend to use the Bayes halo, like people targeting on quasars or radio galaxies. But there's a big problem about the small duty cycle of the Bayes tracer, like only 1% of the dark matter, 10 to 12 dark matter halo will turn on a quasar phase. So your searching is very incomplete. And also, people use the galaxy redshift survey, but you know, getting the redshift at 2 to 3 galaxy, typical galaxy at 2 to 3, is very time consuming. So the survey volume is very small. So a more complete technique to search for galaxy overdensity from larger survey volume will be very good. So we start to think about if Lyman alpha forest can help. So here is our the cosmological simulation. Here's a quick quasar sideline that pass through the intergalactic medium. As long as it hit a high overdensity environment, high overdensity, it will leave a signature on the Lyman alpha forest. So we name this kind of superposition of Lyman alpha forest as a coherently strong Lyman alpha forest, called COSLAS. Another very good thing is that the Lyman alpha forest has a huge survey volume. We already get a huge survey volume in Lyman alpha forest at Z of greater than 2, like the Sloan boss plus the extended boss. And the total survey volume is already 2 orders of magnitude than any high redshift galaxy survey by now. Right. And so we think that there is a very good advantage of using Lyman alpha forest. So we start to do the n-body simulation, to do the cosmological simulation to study the correlation between one-dimension optical depth and three-dimension mass. So from the cosmological simulation, it seems that the correlation of the one-dimension optical depth and three-dimension mass do peak at the scale of 10 to 20 megaparsecs it's very, very good because 10 to 20 megaparsec is typical spatial extent of the proto cluster. And we further compare, study the cumulative probability function of the mass in a 20 megaparsec cube in the cosmological simulation. So the yellow shows the mass traced by very the massive dark halo, matter halo is it's the dark matter halo of the typical quasar. It's 10 to 12 solar mass dark matter halo. You can see that it's indeed tracing some high mass over density, but a significant fraction is still in the mean density, tracing the mean density. But the coherently strong lemma of a forest very effectively traces the very high mass range. So the coherently strong lemma of a forest absorption could be a very powerful way of tracing the highly matter over density. So here is an actual example in our cosmological simulation. So you can see that the biggest large scale structure at Z of 2.5 in our cosmological simulation effectively traced by a coherently strong lemma of a forest, like the superposition of the lemma of a forest. So our next question is how to select. So we know that there's a good correlation at 20 megaparsec, but how to select this coherently strong lemma of absorption. So I introduce my paper, our paper. So if you're interested in the detailed technique, just read the paper. And so the bottom line is that we have already found a technique to search for the coherently strong lemma of a forest. So our next step is to do the imaging to really demonstrate we found an overdensity traced by the coherently strong lemma of a forest. So here is the first field we have done. So here we select a particular interesting field. In this field, there are a group of the strong lemma of a forest, and two of them has the highest optical depths on 15, 20 megaparsec. And we do a narrow band, load the narrow band to a KPO 4 meter, a proper narrow band, and we indeed reveal a significant overdensity at Z of 2.3. So, and we use a large binocular telescope to spectroscopy confirm the overdensity. Here I just show the spectra of the lemma alpha emitter, OZ lemma alpha emitter. And the density peak has an overdensity of 10.8, making this field the highest overdensity the people discovered by now at Z greater than 2.3. So very interestingly, in the density peak, we also discovered a giant lemma alpha nebula. Giant lemma alpha nebula with a spatial extent of more than 400 kiloparsec and located in the very the largest size compared with all the lemma alpha nebula people have been discovered. And more interestingly, this lemma alpha nebula has associated with a strongly extended carbon 4 and helium 2. So it's never detected in the previous lemma alpha nebula. It's a huge kinematics of the metal line never seen in the other lemma alpha nebula. The interpretation of the slug nebula, the giant lemma alpha nebula, is just that there's a gas sitting there photoionized by quasar. The velocity is very small, but we see our kinematics is huge, like has double peak, one blue, one red, and the spatially extent of the 30 kiloparsec. So we think, is this a strong evidence that there is a shock by the outflow? So here is the puzzling. And also I would like to introduce, we already got the preliminary narrowband imaging on a sample of the other field traced by the coherently strong lemma alpha forest. And interestingly, we also discovered some very bright lemma alpha nebulae. Note that our narrowband survey is still very shallow, but such bright lemma alpha nebulae are very hard to find in the random narrowband survey. So is our technique a more efficient way to find lemma alpha nebulae? So I think probably yes, because we particularly select the gas over density, and in the gas over density at the ratio 2 to 3, there are also associated with the high star formation rate, and the enhanced UV background plus the gas over density may yield the high efficiency for detecting the lambda alpha nebulae. So I would like to introduce some of our follow-ups. So I think the thing is that we already got enough data for answering some big questions I raised in the very beginning of my talk. Like using CAG, we already got the spectra for 100 galaxies in the most massive overdensity at ratio 2.3, and we can fully map the 3D structure and conduct an initial tomography study. And also we got our Hubble program approved, and we're gonna use the 10 mosaic pointing to map the field, and we will answer the first time if there's a density morphology relation at Z of 2.3. So, and also I'm planning to doing some IR follow-up, and we already got the 20-hour imaging data, and we're gonna do some follow-up spectroscopy using mouse wire to study the quenching fraction. So to see if the galaxy start to quench at D of 2.3. So if you have more idea, I'm very, very happy to collaborate. And also for the Lambda Alpha Nebula, we discovered we plan to use the cosmic web imager to study the nature. We already got the time for 2 years, but we didn't got any data due to the wet weather, so we're gonna keep trying. So here is my summary. Especially, I would like to stress that the future survey, like the Sloan 4, the HIDEX, the DAD-Z, or prime focus spectrograph, gonna be a gain, a huge gain for this kind of study. So thank you very much.
We have time for a few questions. Okay. I have. Did you have one? Go ahead.
I was just going to ask if you had any idea what net output power was necessary to. What was the net output power?
Net output power.
In order to create that huge blob that you found.
Right. The lambda alpha energy is like 10 to 44, like five times 10 to 44.
And right. If you scale that, if you scale take a typical AGN right. spectrum.
Right. But I haven't done that detailed calculation, but the ionizing parameter is like range from -2 to -1. So it could be a very ultra luminous quasar that doing the photoionization or the powering the lambda alpha nebula. But the thing is that we didn't see the bright source in the center of the lambda alpha nebula. So we think maybe there is an AGN, but strongly obscured AGN. So you need to go to the mid-infrared to figure out the bolometric luminosity of the animal. Yes.
Out of curiosity, for the highest density protoclusters, uh-huh. are the Lyman alphas actually suppressed rather than increased? And can you comment on whether you're actually anti-correlated in those densities of all regions, the nodes, say, of the?
That's definitely a very good question, yes. So I think the short answer is like, seems that Z higher than 2, so the overdensity still correlate with the star formation. And maybe the quenching process may happen at deeps lower than 2 or something like that. But we're gonna figure that out. So we do have an infrared program. We're gonna figure out the quenching fraction in our protocluster. We'll see the real hole.
Any other questions? Okay, if not, then thank you.